going to show you how to do something really cool with WordPress today. And sometimes you might be in a situation where you need to edit a file or remove a file that's uploaded to your web server. And typically that would involve logging into your cPanel if you have it and doing some technical things to get to your files. Or you would have to have FTP access, an FTP program. You'd configure it all and connect in that way. However, there's a easy way to do it in WordPress, and I'm going to show you how to do that right here and right now. So there's a plugin called WP File Manager. I have it pulled open. All you have to do is log into WordPress, go to Add New Plugins, and do a search right there for WP File Manager, and it pulls up. I already have it installed, and I'm going to show you what it looks like and how to configure it, but not in that order. I'm going to show you how to configure it and then what it looks like. So I already have it installed and activated, and it just adds a new option right here on the left, File Manager. When you have your mouse, click on Configuration. Now, what's important is right here where it says Default Home Location, you have to enter ... Just go ahead and enter that and you're going to be fine. That says the file manager is going to take you to the root of your WordPress installation. You'll see what I mean in a second. And then you have these choices of permissions. Now, the reason I'm doing this is because I need to add and then edit a function file, and I'm going to do that for a different video, and I thought this would just be a lot easier. So here's the permissions. Now I've gone ahead and check marked all of them. By default, they're not going to be checked, so you can just decide what permissions you want. Now if you're the only one that has access to your login, you're going to be fine just checking them all. But if multiple people have access, you might want to think about each option that you check. So I've got the create file, create folder, allow download, etc., etc. I just have them all checked. Here you can choose which extensions can be edited. So for instance, a PHP file you want to edit, a TXT file, these types of files that are text-based and contain code you want to edit. Don't edit this unless you need to and you know what you're doing. There's a default list of extensions that are editable, and there's other things right here. So anyways, just make your changes, click on Save Changes, and now when you click on File Manager, it's going to pull up all of your files. Now, if you're familiar at all with WordPress, you know that your plugins and your themes are in this content folder here. So I can just click on it, and now I can see my plugins folder, my themes folder. So I got a ton of plugins because I only use this for testing. So I can click on plugins, and then bam, I've got this whole huge list of plugins listed. Now, if I want to go back up, I can hit the two dots, and that just takes me up a level. So I can click on themes, and I can see all my themes here. And for instance, here is a child theme that I created, and I want to add a file to it. So I'll just click on create new file right there, and it's going to be called functions.php, and then click on create. And so now I've got a function file here, and then because I enabled permissions, I can actually edit it right here. Actually, I'm missing the view and edit hourglasses, and I think I might have made an error in the configuration. So let me go back to the configuration and enable that. I just assumed when this said default editable file extension list that these were enabled by default, but I think I got that wrong. You actually have to enter your file extensions here that you want to have the ability to edit. So for right now, I'm just going to put PHP, and then I'm going to click Save Changes, and now I'm going to go back to my child theme. So File Manager, I'm going to click on Content, Themes, and Child Theme. Okay, so now I've got the edit option enabled here. So let's see when I click on it. If it works, I'm going to click a save and exit. And oh, it did. So the bite size increased. Let me click on edit again. There it is. So okay, so yeah, so it does work. You just have to go and properly configure it. I didn't. I made some assumptions. Even I get things wrong. So, and you can do lots of other cool things like delete files. You can download a file, edit it on your local computer, and then upload it. There's a lot of things that this does that will make your life easier in case there is any problem that you run into WordPress. There was a prior video I did where you had to FTP in to fix something, and this would just make life so much easier for you. So anyways, I hope you find some benefit in this video and you enjoyed it, and we'll see you in the next one. Hey, we'd appreciate it if you took a moment to click on the thumbs up button and to share this video with your friends. Also, please subscribe to our YouTube channel and take a moment to go over to our website, leave us a comment, ask us a question, but sign up for our newsletter. Don't have enough time for all this WordPress stuff? Then have the experts install and configure WordPress for you. We'll install, configure, and optimize WordPress for free. All you have to do is sign up for a new hosting account from one of our recommended providers. For more information, visit WPCrafter.com/free install. Thanks again for watching this video, and make sure you connect with us on these social networks.